failover setup for Teltonika RUT240. Before we dive into the steps for setting up failover on your Teltonika RUT240 router, let's take a moment to understand the importance of failover in maintaining seamless connectivity. Having a reliable internet connection is essential for both your personal and professional activities. Whether you're browsing the web, streaming content, or running critical business operations, any interruption in your internet connection can lead to frustration and financial losses. This is where failover comes into play. With Teltonika's failover option, you can have both a primary WAN wired connection and a secondary mobile connection. If the primary connection encounters issues such as downtime, the router seamlessly transitions to the secondary connection, keeping you online without any noticeable interruption. Now that we understand the significance of failover, let's proceed to the steps for setting it up on your Teltonika RUT240 router. Failover setup. First things first, if you haven't done the initial setup yet for your router, we have a video on this as well. Check out the link in the description below to see how to do this in a few simple steps. Once that's done, proceed to the next step. Go to 192.168.1.1 in the browser of your choice and sign into your device. Now go to the Network tab in the left-hand menu. Select Failover. Turn on the options for wired and mobile connections. By doing this, your WAN connection will be the primary connection and your mobile connection will be secondary. Click Save and Apply. Now your router is set up for failover. In the event of any disruption, it should automatically switch over to your mobile connection. But first, let's make sure it's set up correctly. Stay on the Failover tab and, after a minute or so, you should see the status column switch to online for your wired and mobile connections. Now, select the Status tab in the menu on the left. Go to Overview. Once all the information has loaded on the screen, you should see Failover as Enabled under the boxes for WAN and Mobile. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and let us know what other videos you'd like to see in the comments below.